Lady loves, so I wanted to share with you all today really quick while I wait for someone on a man's journey and why pressuring a man into any sort of situation, why it's kind of not conducive to being in something sustainable, okay? So, and the reason why I'm doing this message is the other day I was speaking with an acquaintance of mine, and he was sharing his story, or his journey as he puts it, on the appreciation of pursuing his journey in his own way, taking the path of life at his own pace. And, you know, being raised in an environment that wasn't always that influential as far as relationships goes and family dynamics. So he never really had that role model or an influence to try to teach him or motivate him in the right direction as far as being in a relationship with someone and understanding your feels and that sort of things. So as most kids in that sort of environment would do is, well, they kind of like play the field. You became a player or F-boy, if whatever you want to consider it as. And that's what happens until he goes to college. That doesn't really work for him. So he ultimately goes into the military. All right, he did that for a few years. He comes back, still somewhat lost on where he should be in life, not necessarily knowing what that journey is. So when it comes to a person's journey, you know, they are likely to take detours in life. Like, let me go down this path and see what this is like, if this is going to work for me, that sort of thing. And encountering certain people and having certain experiences, it just began to teach him. And when it came to dating, you know, it was kind of like more of the same, like the women were trying to change him or trying to pull him in one direction. He still wasn't feeling it. And even if he was stable, like financially and economically, he says he wouldn't have chosen them anyway. So still somewhat quite lost for quite some time. He eventually meets his person, you know. She's what he's been waiting for, what he's needed all this time. Someone who was patient with him and didn't apply any sort of pressure. And within weeks of dating her, he realized that this is the one for me. This is the person that I am willing to change for, you know. She was the game changer for him. And that was when he realized that the chapter that he was in, or that journey, had just ended and a new was about to begin. And she became an influence to him and motivated him indirectly, to the point to where, you know, they marry, they have children, he pursues his career choice and finds another sort of skill or niche. He now has a published coloring book because of that. And he says, "Kara, you know what? I am so grateful that I was patient with myself and I somewhat believed in myself, even if I wasn't aware of that, and gave myself a chance to take that journey that I was supposed to take, have those experiences, go through those detours and make choices for myself versus having that done for me. You know, I wouldn't be where I am spiritually, mentally, and emotionally now had I not done that." And he said, "I'm so grateful for the journey that was chosen for me and the path that I took." See, and so the point that I'm trying to make is that when we pressure a man, for whatever reason, it could be to hurry up and say, "I love you." And the question is, like, why do you want this person to love you so badly? You know, is it because you're waiting to purchase that dream wedding gown, or you want them to hurry up and have a certain level of success? You know, get that bachelor's degree so that they can make more money, or reach out to their superiors for a new promotion. Like, what is the motivation behind that? What is the intent? Like, is it really because you care about that person's well-being and their future, or is it more for selfish type reasons? Because that's what it usually comes off as. Like, you want me to get to this level to benefit you. And here's why I believe why that is so, why it feels that way. Because if you are a woman, and I'm talking about primarily cisgender women here, if you are a woman of high standards and you have a high level of requirements, maybe not the highest, but they're kind of up there, and you choose someone who is not on your level, yet you see their potential, and that's where that force and that pressure comes in. So when you try to push them in the direction that you see fit for your well-being to benefit you, is it because that you know if you don't hurry up and get this person to your level or close to it, that people from the outside will begin to question, well, I know she's kind of high maintenance, or she has a certain level of requirements. Is she settling? You know, that kind of becomes the question. And I believe that's how you feel and think as well. So you're trying not to settle, so you're trying to push this person in the direction to where you are. And that is not fair, because we all have to live life at our own pace. We have to learn on our own and in our own way so that we can appreciate life. And when we have our accomplishments, we're far more likely to be appreciative versus someone saying, well, you need to do this and hurry up and get this degree and I'll show you. Here, let me help you. No. And that's unfair, and that's not how it should be. So when you pressure a man, you're taking him off the path that he needs to be on in order to experience life. You understand? Like, for instance, I can get personal with you and be quite candid. My ex is 6 years older than I am. He wasn't where I was mentally as far as being ambitious and trying to achieve certain goals. And that's okay. No pressure. Don't allow me to pressure you at all. You stay right where you are until you figure it out and allow me to move on, you know? If you can't roll with me, allow me to roll over you and keep it moving. I do my thing. God bless you. I wish you the best. And that's how it has to be. Everyone has their path and their journey, and it has to be understood as well as respected. Because when it isn't, that's when you get problems from your person later on. And they may not have the level of confidence and or esteem to know that they should let something like this situation go. But because they may not have that level of confidence and esteem, so they stay in it to try to make themselves feel better when they know they shouldn't, okay? So that's all I wanted to share with you guys. Please just appreciate a man's journey and their process. And if they're not for you, well, then you should gladly just step away for a while and let them make that achievement on their own, okay? Well, I thank you all so much for joining me today. That is all for now. Until next time.